हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन द पोएम स्प्रिंग बाय कार्ला कस्किन। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द पोएम स्प्रिंग, फर्स्ट वी शुड नो अबाउट कार्ला कस्किन। कार्ला कस्किन वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 17th July 1932 इन न्यूयॉर्क, यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स। शी हैड हर एजुकेशन फ्रॉम एंटियोक कॉलेज and Yale University. For higher studies, she went to Yale University. She has two children, Nicholas and Julia. What is her occupation? She was an author, illustrator, poet. And children? Mostly she wrote for children. She got many awards. There are many awards. I have only mentioned two awards here. So, the awards which she got were Children's Books of Distinction Award and American Library Association Award. But she got many awards. Then, she died on August 20, 2009 at Seattle, Washington, United States. Okay, children. So, let's begin and understand what is there in the poem Spring by Carla Kaskin. Now there are a few questions for you. Can you tell me the season in which you can see flowers everywhere? It is all green. There is greenery all around. And the birds chirp and the sun is bright. Which season is that? Yes, you are right. That is spring. And spring comes after long winters. You know, after long winters, you enjoy spring season. Now, in winters, can you go out and play? No, you cannot go out and play because it is very cold outside. You have to stay indoors. But when spring season comes, all the children are out. They can play, they can dance, they can shout, they can run. Right? And you can see the beauty in the nature also. Okay. So, in this poem, the poet has tried to explain the beauty of spring season and how a little girl enjoys it. So, Spring is a lovely poem written by Carla Kaskin. The central idea of the poem is welcoming spring after a long winter. The poem opens with the speaker. Now, the speaker is a little girl. It can be the poetess as a little girl, or she has depicted this poem with the help of a little girl, telling us about her reaction with the onset of spring. So now, children, I will explain the poem Spring to you stanza-wise. So, children, let's begin with the poem Spring. The first stanza is, I am shouting, I am singing, I am swinging through trees, I am winging sky high with the buzzing black bees. Now, what does this mean? So, this child, she is very happy because it is spring season now. And what is she doing? She is shouting. She is saying, I am shouting, I am singing. She is even singing a song. I am swinging through trees. She is swinging through the trees. I am winging sky high. Winging means flying. So she is flying up high in the sky with the buzzing black bees. The way black bees fly, the girl, this child is also flying. You can imagine, children, in this poem that you are this child. So, now when you recite this poem, you will say, I am shouting, I am singing, I am swinging through trees, I am winging sky high with the buzzing black bees. Let's move to the second stanza. Now, in this stanza, children, this child is comparing herself with various things. What are they? I am the sun, I am the moon, I am the dew on the rose. I am a rabbit whose habit is twitching his nose. So here, the child is comparing herself with the sun. She's saying, I am the sun. Okay, I have made these pictures to make it clear. I am the moon. I am the moon. I am the dew on the rose. This is a rose. Now, what is dew, children? When early in the morning, if you go in a park or if you have a garden in your house, you can see small droplets on flowers, on grass, on trees. They are called dew. That is dew. Dew drops. Okay. In Hindi, we say oski boonde. So, I am the dew on the rose. I am a rabbit whose habit is stretching his nose. Now, she is telling us that she is a rabbit. And the habit, you know, if you have seen a rabbit keeps on moving his nose. There is a twitching means to make a quick, sudden movement. So, rabbit's nose is always moving. So, she is saying, I am a rabbit whose habit is twitching his nose. Now, children, here I have explained that whenever a comparison is made, that is called metaphor. A direct comparison is made. Like when she is telling us, I am the sun. Okay. I'm explaining this along with this poem so that you understand what is a metaphor and what is a simile. Here, the poet has used metaphor. What is metaphor? A metaphor is used to make a comparison. Okay. Whenever a comparison is made, that is called a metaphor. But when you make this comparison, you do not use the words like and as. It does not have words like and as used in a simile. Words like and as, you can get confused that simile is also making a comparison. Yes, we do make comparison. We compare in a simile also, but whenever it is a simile, we use the words like and as. But in metaphor, we do not use these words. See the examples. He is as busy as a bee. Now here, comparison is made between a person and a bee, and we are using the word as. He is as busy as a bee. So this is a simile. But now, when we do make a comparison directly, we are making that person a bee, then it is called a metaphor. See this example. He is a busy bee. Now here we are not using the words like and as. So this is a metaphor. So I hope metaphor and similes are clear. In this poem, the poet has used metaphor. The comparison is made, that is the direct comparison. I am repeating second stanza. Now it will be very much clear to you. I am the sun. I am the moon. I am the dew on the rose. I am a rabbit whose habit is stretching his nose. So children, let's move to the third stanza. I am lively. I am lovely. I am kicking my heels. I am crying, come dance to the fresh water eels. So here, the child is telling us that she is full of enthusiasm. She is full of life. She is very happy with the onset of spring season. I am lively. I am lovely. I am kicking my heels. She is kicking her heels because she is very, very happy. I am crying, come dance to the fresh water eels. She is calling these fishes, freshwater fishes. Eels are thin fishes found in fresh water. So she is calling these fishes to dance with her. Do you think the fishes will come and dance with her? No, the fishes will not come and dance with her. But this is this child's imagination. And she is calling these fishes to dance with her because she is very happy. She is outdoors. She can enjoy in the spring season. It is no longer winter and she is out in the garden, or you can say in the field. I am racing through meadows without any coat. I am a gambolling lamb. I am a light leaping goat. I am a bud. I am a bloom. I am a dove on the wing. I am running on rooftops and welcoming spring. Now, the child is telling us that she is, I am racing. Racing here means running through meadows. She is racing like the lamb, the goat. Okay. So, she is running through meadows. Meadows are the fields with green grass without any coat. Now, here she is stressing that she no longer has to wear a coat the way she used to wear in the winters. She is very happy. This line also tells us that she doesn't like to wear winter clothes. I am racing through meadows without any coat. I am a gambling lamb. Now again, children, here comparison is there. I have taught you what are metaphors. She is comparing herself with a lamb. I am a gambling lamb. I am a light leaping goat. I am a bud. I am a bloom. I am a dove on the wing. In this line, I am a dove on the wing means a dove that is flying. So she is like a dove that is flying. I am running on rooftops and welcoming spring. So why is she doing all these things? Because she is welcoming spring season. Now here, children, the metaphors used are, she has compared herself with lamb, goat, bud. What is bud? When the flower does not bloom. That is Kali in Hindi. Then bloom is a flower, a full-blown flower. Then a dove. So I hope this poem is clear to you. I have explained it stanza-wise with the poetic device which is used here, that is metaphor. And I have tried to explain it with the help of the picture. So if you will memorize these pictures, you can imagine what the child is telling us. So children, recite this poem and understand. I have explained everything in this video. Thank you.